Renowned chef Father Leo Patalinghug and Michael Foley have published a new book, Dining with the Saints, A Sinner's Guide to a Righteous Feast. A spin-off of the book Drinking with the Saints, written by Foley, the book aims to encourage families to eat healthy, hearty meals together at their kitchen table, a concept that's tragically become foreign in a lot of American households. And joining me now is Father Leo Patalinghug, author of the new book, Dining with the Saints, A Sinner's Guide to a Righteous Feast. Father Leo, thanks so much for joining me today. Talk to me about the inspiration for this book. You know, you've been cooking for decades now, so why now did you choose to come out with this new and exciting venture?
Because I had nothing else to do, Prudence, really. It really is a pleasure to be with you all, and thanks for having me. This book came about because of an invitation. Regnery asked if I was willing to collaborate with a very, very talented co-author by the name of Michael Foley, and he's a historian. He wrote a previous book called Drinking with the Saints, and I was a fan of that book because it showed how, as Catholics, we are not, how do you say, so strict with our diet. We have dietary disciplines, but we as Catholics are allowed to eat and drink everything. And so the beauty of this book was really showing how the saints are so human, that there was a kind of a movement to honor the saints, and it had to do with food. And so I wanted to bring that historicity to the modern dinner table and make sure that saints are invited to their home suppers.
Amen. What a beautiful thing. And Father, talk to me about some of your favorite recipes in the book.
I've got several, actually, and some of them are kind of unique. Let me just give you an example. So in Scotland, they celebrate Saint Margaret of Scotland with a haggis. And haggis is a very unique meal. And so what I did was I took the ingredients of haggis, most of it, and I kind of translated it for the modern sensibility. So that was a fun thing. St. Francis of Assisi has two recipes attributed to him because he's a great saint and everybody knows him. They think that he's so austere, and he was. But he had a special love for these almond cookies. So I took an almond cookie recipe, and just to kind of, I'm going to quote Emeril here, kick it up a notch, I dropped in a dollop of Nutella. So, you know, even though he was a very austere, very disciplined, he fasted a lot kind of saint, well, on his feast days, the Assisi people, the people of Assisi, they go all out. And they will definitely make these almond cookies, eating it to remember him.
Oh, that sounds delicious. I recently got into almonds, so that's a recipe I'm going to have to try out. Father Leo, talk to me about how in this fast-paced world, how much of a difference sitting together with your family and having a meal can make, especially when there are so many things that are kind of coming up against the nuclear family right now, against the idea of traditional family values.
Yeah, preach it, Prudence. That's exactly what I've been doing for, you know, most of my priesthood, is reminding families that what we do at the church around the Lord's altar, the dinner table for the Lord, is something that we have to replicate in our own homes, because we are the domestic church. And now more than ever, when there is an attack on trying to destroy the dignity and the innocence of the nuclear family, especially children, they are being indoctrinated in schools. Where else can they actually learn how to process all these things but at the dinner table? So the studies show, and this is coming from CASA, the Center of Addictions and Substance Abuse at Columbia University. If you want to reduce drug addiction in your children, teen pregnancy, teen suicide, plus improve their testing scores, the number one factor is a regular family meal. And if you invite holiness to that dinner table, grace transforms it into a desk where the greatest lessons in life are learned. Mm-hmm. And if mom and dads, if you don't feed your children, I am sure that the devil will. And that's what's happening. We are allowing other people to feed the minds of the and the souls of our children. And I'll be honest with you, we are what we eat. So we gotta feed them something good.
Well said, Father. Thank you for bringing up that powerful statistic. And, you know, this seems like a simple solution to a lot of the world's problems, but to families with children, sometimes scheduling in extra time to have a meal together can seem kind of like an impossible task in this busy world. So what's one piece of practical advice that you would give to them, Father?
Well, I will say that nothing is impossible with God. All right, so we got to know that even though things seem so out of our control, if you don't control your schedule, then the devil will. Right. It's up to us to make family meals not an important, but a necessary part of your schedule, because that is where you prove you are a family by all of the virtues that come from hospitality: patience, humility, obedience. And I say obedience because if you are serving good food, your kids will listen to you because they can't talk with their mouth full.
Father Leo, thank you for coming alongside families in the way that you do. Such a unique witness to the beauty and the power of the Lord working in our lives. God bless you. Congrats on this book. I can't wait to dig into it.
Cheers. God bless.